Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. You're welcome to Skin Talk with D. On this channel, I do skincare product reviews and I give tips on my videos on how to care for your skin. And if that's something that you're interested in, definitely do keep on watching. If you like my face and you like my hair, I actually reviewed and installed this hair on my other channel. So if you're interested in finding out about this hair, guys, let me tell you a secret. It's a synthetic hair. Synthetic, yeah. Don't tell anybody I told you. This is a synthetic hair, guys. So if you want to know how to look this good on a budget, I advise you subscribe to that channel, because I'm going to be reviewing more and more affordable hairs like this that will make you slay, and nobody's going to know, like nobody. Okay, so do me a favor by subscribing to that channel. It's still an extension of this channel, but that one is on hair and skin and makeup. I'm gonna leave it linked down in the description bar, and let me know that you subscribe to that channel from here. Let me know that you're a loyal fan that went over to my other channel. I do see some of you from here already on that channel, and I really appreciate you guys for all the love and the support. So in today's video, guys, the Harmattan is gradually creeping in, and the Harmattan is my favorite season. But it is the season where my skin suffers the most, and I'm going to tell you guys why. I have combination skin, but the most part of my skin actually is dry, especially my palm and under my feet. And during the Harmattan, I normally experience this scaliness on the skin. So I'm here to help you guys to no longer suffer like I used to do during the Harmattan. And I'm going to tell you guys products and things that can help you out here to make sure that your skin looks moisturized and is healthy and will not crack, that your skin will not be looking tight. You're trying to smile, it's as if you're trying to tear your skin. So let's start. Okay, the first thing I want to talk about is oil. Oils are going to be your friend this period. You can actually use oils or butters depending on you. You can buy raw shea butter, but I find out that raw shea butter on some people's skin, it actually burns their skin. It's not so good. So people actually react to raw shea butter. So I would advise that even if you are using raw shea butter, still mix it with a cream. For me, I don't like petroleum jelly. Petroleum jelly too can be an option, but I don't like petroleum jelly because it gives me shortness of breath. I hardly can breathe if there's a product that contains petroleum jelly. I'm sorry about this patch here. It's the glue I used and it cleaned off my makeup. I actually did a baby hair here, but I've combed it out, so that's why. So in case you're looking at me like, what kind of patchy makeup is this? So like I was saying, so you can use butters. For me, I personally love cocoa butter, because cocoa butter is like a healing butter. It helps you. One thing I noticed with cocoa butter is that it's like soap. It cleans your skin. It cleans your skin. It cleans your complexion. It helps your scars heal faster. And I wasn't having, like, you know how you go to the sun and come out and your skin is looking discolored. Your skin, I mean, has different colors. If you're using cocoa butter, you're not going to experience that. So one thing you should use during this period is you should make sure you have butters or oils. For oils now, I'm going to tell you the oil that you should use. Number one, the Neutrogena oil is a very moisturizing oil. The second oil I highly recommend during the Harmattan is the Pierce baby oil. It is very thick and it takes time to evaporate from your skin. Okay, so these are oils that you can use this period. So yeah, then for lotion, I don't know if you have heard about St. Ives. St. Ives lotion is very moisturizing. I was very uncomfortable when I used it during the rainy season. You know, the rainy season is actually very hot, but the dry season too can get hot, especially towards February, March, April. But the difference is that sweat, your sweat dries faster. Okay, but the rainy season is humid, so you are sweating, you are just uncomfortable, your body is sticky. That's the difference. So during the rainy season, I could not tolerate this lotion because it was too moisturizing. And like I said, I hate feeling like there's something on my skin. And so I found out that, oh, this lotion would be a very handy lotion in the winter and in the Harmattan if you are in the tropics like me. So St. Ives lotion is very moisturizing. This is a lotion that you should buy, especially if you have dry skin, in combination with the butters that you're going to be mixing with it. Another lotion that I would advise you also get this period is the Palmer's cocoa butter, or if you can lay your hands on the Elizabeth cocoa butter. It is very moisturizing and it is lightweight. it was not heavy on my skin. It was not so thick on my skin. It was not like those kind of lotions that when you apply, you feel like you have creams. I mean that you have cream. But no. It is very moisturizing. At the same time, very, very lightweight. You're not even going to feel it on your body. So mixing your butters or your oils with this product, the St. Ives or the cocoa butter, is going to work magic for you. Then another thing that you would need this period again is lip balm or wet lips. The wet lips that I recommend this period is the Absolute Wet Lips, or if you can lay your hands on the Usha's wet lips. These two wet lips, guys, this period, you will thank me. This period, they are very thick, they stay long, and they moisturize the lips so well. And even if your lip is peeling, it makes it so soft for you to use a washcloth to just remove the lips, your lip that is actually peeling out. Do you understand? It's very, very moisturizing. So the Absolute Wet Lips or the Usha's Wet Lips, yes. Then you can also use the Nivea Lip Balm. I love the Nivea Lip Balm. The Vaseline one, I don't know. For somebody that has dry skin and my lips get really dry, the Vaseline one didn't really moisturize me the way I would like. Vaseline or Chapet. But I would advise that you get the Nivea Lip Balm. That's, is it burgundy or pink or what, the dark pink? I'm going to leave a picture as I'm talking. That lip balm should be your friend so much this period. And also, you want to make sure that, you know, you are having a lot of warm baths this period, and having hot baths or warm baths this period tends to strip your skin of moisture. Warm baths actually open up your pores, so it tends to strip your body of moisture. You find that when you come out of the shower, your skin gets drier than usual, especially if you're using hot or warm water this period. So what I would advise, that you pour a little bit of oil into your water before taking your bath. This also works for people that normally have itchy skin. Immediately after coming out of the shower, your skin begins to itch. Pour oil into the water. For me, I don't take my bath with hot water for no reason at all. I don't know, it's not just my preference. Hot water makes my skin itch. It just makes me feel very uncomfortable, and I like to enjoy myself when I'm taking my bath. I take my time. I spend a lot of time in the shower, so hot water doesn't let me have that luxury. So I really don't enjoy bathing with hot water, but it's unavoidable this period. Sometimes I might really need to, especially if I need to take my bath in the morning and go out. And let me tell you something, this Ramadan period, a lot of people don't take their bath, especially in the morning. I don't blame them though, because it's really cold. So I would advise that you pour oils like the Pierce oil, Neutrogena oil, any oil you have, pour it into the, I would have said olive oil, but olive oil is a very light oil. This time it's not going to be advisable. But in your bath, yes, you can pour it into your bath water so that you come out of the shower still moisturized and your skin would not be totally stripped of its moisture. I hope you guys would find, of course, you would find this particular video very helpful, and I hope it's able to help you this Ramadan period. So you know the drill. Subscribe to the channel, like this video, share this video with your friends, with your family, and everybody. And till I see you guys in my next one, bye.